everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP. Today, I'm PvP... Oh, it starts right off good. Today, I'm PvPing with my Dark Insolent build. And we're starting right off with a bit of lag. Well, the Dark Insolent build, it is a build that, of course, uses all the Insolent things in the game. Being the armor of the Insolent, then the shield of the Insolent, and the... Mace of the Insolent, and like you saw here, with the shield of the Insolent, I can spell parry, which I used a bit. I wanted to use that, like here, which it got a huge buff and it's now so good. You can literally parry, set up parry everything, like reaction parry, except of this soul greatsword. This is kind of, I tried it a few times and. Didn't work out quite well, so yeah, I lost a few fights with that. Yeah, the shield can parry spells, and the Mace of the Insolent can shoot hexes and spell and miracles. So I did a Dark Insolent build, being so the shield and the mace with dark infused, like you know the lore behind the Insolent. It's it is the they are clerics, elite clerics, which ventured into the thing, the crypt, to conquer it, and they lost, and they got influenced by the dark, and they basically got screwed. And so the mace and the shield and so have now dark in it. So my Insolent build shoots resonant and great resonant soul projectiles, and the then I have also for the wake up hits my don't know how it is these two AoE spells, like I have, we see it in this fight also. So I have good time most times using this build, because you can screw your opponent up a bit with these attack cancels that are pretty easy to do, and so it is quite fun to play with it, but it can become a bit tactical at times. So if your opponent is also low on health, like you see later in a very long fight, it can be a bit... Here you saw this Darkstorm is my AoE spell. Props for my opponent that he didn't heal, because I invaded him as a blue, so... I also did a few root gestures, but also only because I am cosplaying. So this guy, I met him two times that you will see. He used his basically Harvest setup with Great Shield and Katana. Of course, not a PvP setup. And Hex and Dark Magic does incredible damage against Harvels, or was it just because it was upgraded or something? But it did quite an awesome damage. This guy, I met him the second time also. First time was it when I tried to parry his Soul Greatsword. Didn't work out well. And this time I tried it again. What was I thinking? What was I thinking? Yeah. Also with this build I did the challenge when I had to basically... GG! Then I had to basically force someone off a cliff without attacking. Which was the most awesome cliff in my whole thingy. You know, yes, my whole challenge video thing, most awesome clip, awesome gank and awesome win. So this, now I am screwed up his summon, and now it's basically a 1v1. Also this guy with a PvE setup, washing pole, and great shield, and Vanguard armor because it's so good. Yeah, I had a good time because I could hit through his shield, and if I didn't screw up that much with fighting against him, I could have won this more easily. Since he wasn't a big PvP guy, I think I tried to backhop parry him here, and I got low on health as a punish from my opponent, so he did a good job, even though he wasn't PvP guy. But who knows? Also, this is like, you see here quite good why the why this most times doesn't work, this guard break. If he just holds his shield up and backs up, then I have a bad time guard breaking him, like this guy did also. It's this guy again, the second time I meet him. This time he tries a bit different thing, and he cannot back up here, so I got the guard break. Which, look at that damage, what the fuck. And I missed that, he tried to heal and he got a great resonance hole in the face. Yay. This guy, typical knight cosplay thing, just a longsword. Longsword and a shield and an armor. Yay. And I got a bit tanky on him. Later I figured out a bit of, now I figured out a bit of his move here. He runs away and takes a circle and comes back with the running attack. So I thought I could do that here. I tried to backstab him for punish of his roll, but he didn't do that. And parry! Boom! Saw that, I saw him coming to me, and I knew he would do a running attack or attacking me, and I kind of thought he would do a running attack, but he didn't do it. He attacked me normally, but also worked quite well. And he killed me, because longswords are fucking ridiculous. And no, 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 because there is no yes, yes, yes gesture in the game, so I got pretty pissed off by that and killed, attacked this guy right away with, because I thought like, oh come on, you also buffing your Sentier Spear, get backstabbed and attacked and get the fuck out. I don't like this. Of course he healed. Why wouldn't he? And I got a bit of damage in my face, nothing too bad though. So yeah, this is how you avoid the running spinning attack if you have a bit of adaptability to you, which you should always have in PvP. So just wait up until he spins, and while he's spinning just roll directly into it. He will spin away, and he will, if you get hit, you will only get hit once. So, yeah, down, yeah, get decapitated, decapitated. You remember this guy when I talked at the beginning? He was one of those players who suck to fight against. Just always running away, then doing just ridiculous stuff, running, circling away, coming in, running away, and just to attack at one point and stunlock you. So I avoided his attacks, I learned from him, his playstyle, waited up his spam, backstabbed him, tried the wake up hit. Of course, for all my luck he got hit there. I tried the thing, and of course he healed, because if your cheap tactic doesn't work, you heal. And now, karma gets you, sucker. Oh man. So this guy I got again pissed off by, by already the look of this guy with his Drake, curved dragon greatsword, and so yeah. And this is the fight that I meant with, this could, this will become a bit tactical. So you see this, I damage him a bit, and at one point he just screws me up completely, and it's like the game, when does the opponent attack, when can I attack first, and there he got me low on health. Oh my god. And yeah, now I have to look, when can I attack, when does he attack, what can we do there? Just circling around, waiting for the opponent to attack, getting in with two attacks. Yeah, I got this. Tried to shoot something, he tried to get in there again. Also props for him not healing, is he? Quite good play here. And what can we do? Going in, going out. Yeah, tactics. Tactical gameplay in Dark Souls. And taking a hit in the air because that he goes in and running attack, and he tries to do the running attack, but since it forces you in one direction, then you... yeah. This guy got invaded and thought like, 3-2-1, let's do my mod. Let's just do a trainer with infinite health, like you see there in the last bit of when I hit him with the great resonant soul, or resonant soul, he had infinite health. Fortunately, he got kicked off the cliff, but he was at the point where he just set up his trainer, which I think, like, what the fuck, get down. This guy also hovels, of course. Hovels, you should instantly expect them, if you damage them a bit, to let they heal, because that's basically what all hovel scrubs do. That's because they are called hovel scrubs. He avoided this quite good, and of course he healed and chucked like crazy. Thought like, what am I gonna do? I'm just continuing backstabbing, because why not? Didn't have the shadow dagger upgraded there, otherwise I would have pulled out this. He got some quite good damage in there. He did a risky attack, so backstabbed again. And yeah, of course he wanted to heal there, so bye bye. Come here, fight me, you sucker. This was one of the best matches I had when I fought in the blue arena and when I fought as blue, as an insolent build. It's like this guy. I like this magic user. He's just doing his magic at the beginning, but that hit me, so that was my fault. I tried to parry that. But also, he's kind of good playing. He's like rolling attacks, back hops, and avoiding things, and but not as scrubby as all of them always trying to heal. Saw that back hop, quite good. Not as scrubby as always spamming O1 with his leg reach thing, because this Moonlight Greatsword has a quite incredible leg reach. I managed to hit him a few times in the roll. That's why you should get adaptability off in. Here is good. Of course, I tried to punish that with the backstab. He did also jumping attacks, which are really risky, and props for this guy. I really like to fight him. Here he delayed his hit. He's just a very good good PvP'er without being overpowered as hell. And that's something that you should really watch out for in PvP. Some good guys who play honorable and don't spam and don't do cheap shit. And yeah, in the end I got him with the rollback step thing here. And this is worth bowing here. So this guy, I did a bad job at fighting him, because we had a bit of lag. We had much lag in the end. So yeah. But in the end I really enjoyed playing as Insolent, because you are quite viable in doing stuff, in fighting as and against mages. So quite cool. He got a resonant soul in the face here, and yeah. And then I swap to the great resonant soul. Of course he tried to heal there, and the great resonant soul damage applied. Now, thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Leave a like, subscribe, comment down below, and I see you all in the next one. Bye bye.